Tell me your stance on fashion and when you get up in the morning and decide to get dressed.
Fashion.
What you're thinking.
Waking up in the morning and deciding to get dressed is probably the longest part of my day. I have too many clothes, so I have too many options, and it's dressing is always so spontaneous. It always depends on the mood, plus the occasion, plus your little badass daring touch that I like to put on my outfit every time. So it's always borderline tough, yet a little sexy sometimes.
You said the word badass, and I admire your edge, and we're not going to zoom in, but I did say that through this dress I saw a piercing, and you said if Access Hollywood is fine with it, I'm fine with it. Yes. And you just like to push the envelope, right?
I mean, really, I don't do things for the response or for the controversy. I live my life like I want to. Like I have fun, and a lot of the clothes I see are usually just the clothes that I like and the clothes that I'm attracted to. Sometimes are sheer, sometimes are bolding, sometimes are very daring. And I'm okay with that. Like, I'm okay with buying a sheer shirt, because if I bought it sheer, that means I was okay with you seeing through it, whether it was my bra or whatever else. I wear it my way. Someone else might wear it with a bra. Someone else might wear it with a tank top. Someone might wear it with booby tape, and someone might wear it with none. And I happen to fall in that category.
So funny. So I assume you're referring to the top the other night that made news.
Yes. I mean, I just like to have fun with clothing. I get caught a lot of times without wearing a bra, according to everyone else, but it was never my intention. Or if I don't wear a bra, that means I didn't want to wear a bra. And it's not usually for attention, it's just because it would mess up the outfit completely.
There are rumors you have a new album for getting out.
Ooh.
Is that true this year?
Actually, I have not started working on new music. I've started working on the new sound, but I haven't started really recording yet. This year, we kind of left a little room to play in other playing fields, like movies, acting, fashion. I'm getting into fashion a lot more, really spearheading it as a designer. And I'm working with several different brands. I started with Armani. I got to design two capsule lines, for one for the fall collection, and the second one was for the current spring collection. And it's fun. I mean, I love designing. I love creating. Creating is something that, you know, a creative person, we love putting out creative ideas and anything that comes to mind. And whether that's through music or fashion or movies, it's just all these different outlets that you get to play with, which is exciting for me.
I know Katy Perry is one of your besties.
Yes.
And I heard you two may be doing a song together. Is that true?
We have been working on this for years. We still are trying to make a song together, Katy Perry and I. She is one of my favorite musicians, as well as one of my favorite people in the industry. She's very uncalculated, very sure of herself, and that's something that's very rare in this industry to find. It's very easy to be persuaded and you know, by all these different outlets, all these different people and all these different cultures, whatever it is. But if you're not sure of who you are as a person, then it's a little difficult to portray that through your creativity, through your visuals, and let people know who you are. And Katie, she's very good at doing that. She was very good at doing that, even meeting her. So we kind of connected really, really, really soon, really quickly.
So that song may come out soon?
The song will probably come out in a while. I won't say it's happening right now, but it's going to happen.
So do you two go get like manicures and pedicures together? It's that type of thing?
We hang out. We have dinner, or we just, you know, bachelorette parties. Whenever we're in the same city, we try to do something, whether it's see each other for 5 minutes for a hug, or whether it's partying all night at some random after party for an award show or something. We try to hang out as much as we can, which is very rarely because we're so busy. She's a busy girl, so am I. But if we're in the same city, we definitely make sure.
So you're big on Twitter, and you were one of the first celebrities to come out about the Coney video and saying, that you wanted to support it. Yes. Do you plan on making a film?
Well, I would say with Twitter, I was completely anti-Twitter for the longest time. And I felt like a really big piece was missing between my fans and I, and that was them knowing who I was as a person, getting them to know me, my personality a little more. And I finally decided, you know what, the only way to do that is to talk with them one-on-one, and I felt like Twitter was the perfect outlet to do that. And Twitter has brought about so many different opportunities, not only for me, but for, you know, other foundations that I can help, like the Kony 2012 Foundation, Invisible Children. We've been very active with them and trying to get the word out and spread the word and get my fans involved, because they're so, the foundation is so driven by youth and their enthusiasm and their stand in things that are not okay. You know, in America, we see things that are not okay and things that are so foreign to us. And in other countries, it's been something that's been going on for a quarter of a century. So for American kids to say, this is not okay, we have that freedom, but we know that freedom shouldn't be a luxury, it's a right. And to get the youth involved with something like that, I'd love to be an outlet, something that can help spread the word. Even if it's to the 14 million fans on Twitter, I'd love to do that. And the Kony 2012 Foundation, the Invisible Children campaign, it's such a powerful, strong message. And it's something that I really want to get involved in, not just on the surface, but I want to get my hands really dirty with that project. So I'm planning on going to Uganda later on this year, even if it's for a day or two, just to really spend some time with the victims and really suss out the whole situation.
And possibly make a film, because I know you...
Absolutely. Invisible Children, they've also been reaching out to me about doing a film. So it's something that I would love to do. And that's why I really want to go to Uganda, so we can really... I want to make it mine. I want to make it something fresh. I want to make it something new, but something very, very powerful and something that speaks to the youth and the people of the world.
And that would come out later this year. You said you were going there, possibly?
Later on this year.
Wow.
Yeah. It can't be past this year. This year has only just started, so we have to do what we can right now. Yeah. Regardless of the backlash, a lot of people associate Invisible Children with finding Kony. Getting Kony famous is not really about Kony himself. The government is dealing with that. Obama has signed on to helping with that, so that's completely out of our hands. Right now, what I'm really interested in and what I'm working with Invisible Children on is really helping the victims. There are thousands, there's so many people and children of these people and their grandchildren and babies being born into this that we need to help. A lot of focus needs to be, you know, diverted onto the kids and the people who actually need the help, and that's where we're putting our focus. It's not really on Kony himself. I really can't do much to find Kony himself, but I can do whatever I can to help the children who've suffered through his
battleship,
his hand on his back.
How much fun was that? I heard I don't want to curse, but you're a badass, like you said in this film.
Thank you.
Tell
so
me
much
about it.
Battleship was super fun. It was such an amazing experience. Working with Peter Berg was, I mean, I was spoiled. I'm spoiled. It really got me interested in working on other films. And Battleship was such an immense experience. It was a lot of action, which I love. A lot of shooting weapons, which was fun. I got to play a really cool character, which is a female. She's a weapons officer. She loves her weapons. She knows them very well inside out. Not only hers, but all the weapons on the ship. And she's one of the guys, which is kind of a little close to my real lifestyle.
Who would win in a fight, you or Brooklyn Decker?
Ooh, well, it depends. Well, real life or the movie.
You're like, real life?
You know what? I don't know. I don't really think about that. Brooklyn Decker in the movie, she plays... fiance, so she's a complete feminine beauty, and she's the beauty in the movie. Mm-hmm. Everything is so tough and grimy, and every time they flash back to her, it's like, really? That blonde chick? She's so gorgeous, and every time you go to her in the film, I saw clips of the film. It's just so annoying, really.
Oh, you should
she's
talk.
So beautiful, and every time they go to me, I'm just like one of the guys, but she's the female in the film, so I don't really compare with her. She's stunning.
You're a blonde now.
I'm a blonde right now.
Is that your favorite hair color?
No.
What's your favorite?
Black. Black is my favorite hair color, hands down. It's so easy. It's almost like I was born a brunette. Really, my natural hair color is like a rusty sand blonde, which is gross. It's like green almost. And I prefer it to be one way or the other. I'm an extremist. So it either has to be all the way blonde or all the way
dark. I've been everywhere, man, looking for someone who can please me, love me all
Rihanna.
Alone.
Rihanna,
I've been
look
everywhere,
up.
Man, looking for you, babe. Looking for you, babe. Searching for you, babe. Where have you been? Cause I never see you.
I'm in New York for a Vita Coco campaign. This is our second campaign. The first one was a little closer to nature. We shot it in Jamaica on the set of Man Down in between takes. It was literally on a coconut tree, on the branch of a coconut tree. This time, it's a little more fun. We're on a stage. We get to shoot it with Terry Richardson, who's an amazing photographer. Everybody knows his work. He's known for his fun shoots and his personality in his shoots. And I worked with him before, so I'm really excited to work with him on such a different project. My flavor being a tropical fruit punch completely dilutes the taste of coconut water if you're not really into it. I love both the original and the fruit punch. There are a couple other flavors that I really love, like the pineapple coconut flavor. Everybody has their own. And that's why we provided such a wide range of flavors so people can get into it. On stage, I have to drink water to keep hydrated, but having Vita Coco on stage helps because it tastes good, but it keeps you hydrated. Viva Vita.
What they did to my hand, man.
All right, I'm gonna give you a choice. You can either have the money and the hammer, or you can walk out of here. You can't have both. What do you want?
I just wanna get out of here.
And don't forget to tell your friends what happens if they fuck around here. You understand?
I'm sorry, I made a bad mistake.
You're fucking right you made a bad mistake. Because if you come back here, we catch either one, we're gonna break your fucking heads and you won't walk out of here. You see that fucking saw? We're gonna use it. You don't fuck around in this place.
Superstar J, let's get it in. Dead to the world. My nigga Lucky Dog, the Mafia,
Operation,
it's a lifestyle,
Mafia,
Superstar,
Brownsville,
Jay.
Y'all already know. For some reason, I don't know why they think.
Why they think that?
Ain't that cool, my wrist icy rap shit.
It's not.
This that gangsta wrist icy clap shit.
Uh-huh.
The mafia, ain't no frontin' in this.
Front.
You violate, I can't find you, I'm gunning your bitch.
That's
it's Lucky Dawn,
like
I know son in the mix.
Uh-huh.
C sunk in the six, 3CL.
Let's go.
With a crispy face, honey, that look like money.
What's up,
with
baby?
My daylight, it look like sunny. What's happening, partner? We living it, you rapping it, partner. That shit you rap about clapping, I'm backing it, partner.
Look.
Leave a nigga leaning, fetal position steaming. I make movies, motherfucker, you scheming? Nah, he ain't scheming. He ain't nothing could help them. All day, I'm a Brooklyn 12 them. I was just waiting, I never felt them. I had the hammer that night, I could have been knelt them. What happened to son? Luck shelved them. Any hood in the world, nigga, luck welcome. I tried to run down my resume, but y'all wanted to see the weapon spray. Okay, that's fine, it ain't a real nigga, I won't blind. I dare whoever nigga play with mines. Yours over there, I stay with mine. Stay with mine. This ain't that cool, my wrist icy rap shit. This that gangsta wrist icy clap shit. The mafia, 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 mafia. This ain't that cool, my wrist icy rap shit. This that gangsta wrist icy clap shit. The mafia, 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 mafia. When all flash, it ain't the bow on his wrist. It's the thing off his hip, about to make y'all go shit. It's real, tell me if it gets realer than this. Love's the general, I give him my wrist. Fuck this. They ain't popping nothing, they got a cork in them. I pop, pop, till you're done, put a fork in them. You was running from them dogs, I was walking them. Welcome to the life, shit is a gamble, welcome to the dice. You hungry? You welcome to a slice. Psych, fuck you pay me. Cause I was fucked up and you was up all crazy. Late nights, I was up all crazy. Studying the hand that God gave me. Lucky dog, pure stand up nigga. Let's go. Put your stamp up nigga, the mafia. Put your camp up nigga. Whole circle full of man up niggas. Can't lose, can't lie. Real nigga that's fly. Rah. This ain't that cool, my wrist icy rap shit. This that gangsta wrist icy clap shit. The mafia, 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 mafia. This ain't that cool, my wrist icy rap shit. This that gangsta wrist icy clap shit. The mafia, 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 mafia.
Looking for a ransom. I can tell you I don't have money, but what I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills I've acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you.
What up, son? Yeah. I'm out to go to the hood, check my son. I'll be right back, son.
Where at? Over there on Picnic Christopher.
Alright, I'll be right back, son.
Let's go.
Son!
Son in the streets, he like luck, I'm flipping one in a week. I'm like, son, that ain't nothing to me. He like luck, you a gunning to me. What you expect, what you want me to be, huh? Son bust out laughing, had his hat in a bugged out fashion. Nice rugby on, good team, my nigga was mashing. I'm like, things looking good in the hood. Son like, you know you keep your foot in the hood. Stop fronting, trying to act like you a rapper. Niggas know that you a pop something. A dummy sleeping, get shot dummy. Son, what up with son? I don't know, luck, son be bugging. They say some bitch fucked him up, but good for him. Cause son used to be cuffing. He right back to what he used to be, nothing. Son was like, luck, the name is buzzing. And please, luck, don't change for nothing. What? Had to look at son. We started playing through a hook at my son. My son, that's my son for real. My son, whole approach is ill. I ain't gotta speak, my son know the deal. My son forever holding me down. That's my son, that's why he roll with me now. My son, that's my son for real. My son, whole approach is ill. My son,
son forever holding me down. That's my son, that's why he roll with me now. Got another son that really don't want me to win. Talk about me any chance he can, but still fuck with me, just in case I blow with the wind. What up, son? What's up, son? My nigga Luck, I see you. Son smiling, but his eyes is evil. Every other word giving me gap. Always talking high, nigga be strapped. I'm like, yeah, yeah, son, relax. I'm getting tired of acting like me and son in school. Think he a gangster, I done this fool. Make him dance, put son in the groove. Have him stepping in the name of Slug. Luck rap is still a dangerous thug. Thought he was blood, now he came with the cuz. Lucky Dawn, I'm your brain on drugs. I'm in the game all four quarters, there ain't no subs. Son, son, you a plain old bug. RK, slap him, get that nigga main no love. My son, that's my son for real. My son, whole approach is ill. I ain't gotta speak, my son know the deal. My son, forever holding me down. That's my son, that's why he roll with me now. My son, that's my son for real. My son, whole approach is ill. My son, forever holding me down. That's my son, that's why he roll with me now.